be. She's gone, she's gone to find another. She no longer cares for me. Don't bury me beneath the willow on her leaping bow tree. Don't dream she hears that I am sleeping, then perhaps she'll think of me.
It is 2011, of course, and interestingly, this is the 100th anniversary of the old apple tree being called the old apple tree. Right now, this tree is the last above ground remnant of Hudson's Bay Company operations here at Fort Vancouver. It's been a lone sentinel, you know, of the Hudson's Bay Company probably for over 100 years now. The U.S. Army received Fort Vancouver from the Hudson's Bay Company in 1860. And actually took care of that property. The Hudson's Bay Company was suing the United States government for the value of Fort Vancouver. And the U.S. Army amazingly took care of it for 6 years. And then, mysteriously, in 1866, a fire sprung up in Fort Vancouver. Actually, 6 or 7 fires sprung up at Fort Vancouver. And although there were 500 soldiers up the hill, the newspaper recounted that it was amazing. None of them could muster themselves to come down and put out the fire. The Army got tired of taking care of a foreign corporation's property that was suing the United States government and burned Fort Vancouver to the ground. So the above ground remnants of that fort were gone. And by 1860, the U.S. Army had removed the Hudson's Bay Company village. And this was the quartermaster's depot. So a whole string of the who's who of the 19th century U.S. Army actually came here. Just to the north of us, or actually northwest, in the cloverleaf of SR-14 and I-5, there was a house, a U.S. Army house, called the Ingalls House. When it arrived here in 1849, it was a prefab house, amazingly. It was built in Boston and shipped around the Horn and was constructed there. In 1852 and 1853, a young Ulysses S. Grant resided in that house. And he was part of the Quartermaster Corps. So less than 100 feet away from here, Ulysses S. Grant was residing. He had to have seen this tree. On his daily walk down to the wharf to check in on the quartermaster stores, he probably walked right by it. In fact, the main road connecting Vancouver Barracks to the wharf was basically just on the east side of this tree. And to me, it's just amazing looking at the history of development in this area that this tree has survived.
We're so proud. 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 We're so proud.